Hey, good morning YouTube. So I picked up a new project. I got this Misty River Canoe. And the kids used to jump on the back of this. And you could tell they bowed and broke these ribs. So I got about like 80 of these to fix up, strengthen it up. I think I have an idea what I'm going to do now. I'm not sure if it's the best, but we're going to try to get this and get this on the water today. I was going to use like these ribs. This. Down to size and put them in there. And maybe rivet them to the sides. But I don't know. I just couldn't seem to find. I need it. I got this sheet of plywood that's in there now. Looks like half inch. Cut that for the size of the bottom and goes. If it's too heavy, I have no choice. I have to use some metal ribs and some rivets. Try to make it lighter. And she's got slight leaks on the bottom. I already know because he told me, the previous owner, because from jumping on the back of the canoe to get in and out of the house. You can see she's a little bowed. Use duct tape. Some of these ribs, where these rivets come through, like especially like here, right? So you see slight little crack, from being loose. Yeah, tape. Apparently they use this like this for a while and stopped the leaks and that, but obviously this is old. This is old. I was going to use the flex seal tape, but you only get like that much in a roll of flex seal tape, so I'd only probably do one pass. So, plywood bottom, screwed, to strengthen the ribs. And I'm gonna use this flex seal. Put it to the test, see if this is as good as what it is on TV. So I'm gonna get to it here, and we'll see if this thing works. Oh, and I'm gonna hook up an engine to this too. We'll see how that goes. Stay tuned. Alright, I just got ahead of myself. I forgot to have the camera on. But as you see, I just had some plastic. I'm just kind of winging it here, but I just attached it. Because, as you can see, it's kind of rounded on the edges. And when I go to cut this plywood to fit in here, I want it to fit snug and, you know, off flat on these ribs. Not like hanging off the side, putting pressure on the side. But yeah, I just kind of cut it like that, a little template. I think I pretty much got it. I might have to adjust it a little bit. But I'm just gonna try to fit this in better and then put it on that plywood here. And we'll try to screw it in. See you in a bit. All right, I just got ahead of myself. I forgot to have the camera on. But as you see, I just had some plastic. I'm just kind of winging it here, but I just attached it. Because, as you can see, it's kind of rounded on the edges. And when I go to cut this plywood to fit in here, I want it to fit snug and, you know, off flat on these ribs. Not like hanging off the side, putting pressure on the side. But yeah, I just kind of cut it like that, a little template. I think I pretty much got it. I might have to adjust it a little bit. But I'm just going to try to fit this in better and then put it on that on that plywood here, and we'll try to screw it in. All right, so I lifted it up with some foam, some pillows or clothes on a cooler lid back there, but basically just to get it off. I stepped in the middle, and she popped back out. So I do got the curve to it. I marked front at that end just so I don't get it mixed up when I move it over to plywood. I got back. It's going to be between that that rib and that rib. Those are the bad ones. I don't really care. It'll save weight too, not having it all the way to the front. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 ribs. 2 screws per side of the ribs. 4. Yeah, I ended up getting these, right? But man, I was way off on the size. I calculated it for 3/4 inch plywood, but I only have 1/2 inch plywood. So, I was off by a bit. Yeah, might as well get the right thing, make sure you don't go through the canoe. Having that, yeah, we're off to Canadian, back to Kent to bring this stuff back, I guess. Say hi to the subscribers. This is Alan. He's been helping me out on this. Brother-in-law, he's been helping me out on this project. I like rolling with him. He's always got that serious radio going. And he's always kind of like a serious dude. This is how we do it in Scotia. Back at the Kent. Get her done. Open sesame. This is the aisle. So many screws here. Little change of plans. Just noticed that Flex Seal spray I bought. It's 24 hours to cure, so it wasn't much. You probably get, I think you get 5 feet on Flex Seal tape. So we're gonna try this Gorilla stuff. Yeah, you seem to get more. Yeah, so 3 meters, 10 feet, as opposed to 5 feet of the Flex Seal. Pretty wide stuff. We'll see how it works. Put it to the test here in a bit. Because we need this canoe in the water today. I'm hoping like in 2 hours. And we are back. I got one side done already. Now this side. And I'm just using using a circular saw. Woo! There we got platform for the canoe. Or should I say platform for the new? Thanks, Alan. All right, guys, I got a little carried away, flipped it over, started on the back side, scrubbed it, and I was going to use that spray, but then I ended up using this stuff because the spray was going to be a 24-hour cure, and this is the Gorilla Glue stuff. It's like tape. It's super thick. That's it there, and it's got a backing on that. But anyways, I'm just going around. This cut ran out. I only had 10 feet. And there's still some more rows I got to do. And that's what she's doing there. She's covering both rows of rivets at a time, right? We'll come back when I get this side done and flip it back around to show you how the inside was all finished. So she finished. I know, got that other tape. There's a couple little holes here on the sides where the seats were. I didn't trust those rivets. Probably look better painted all black or something. But yeah, that's what we got. Every rivet lying, except for the bottom keel. but that seems all right. We'll know when we get it in the water. All right, flipper. And you see, near the center of the ribs, I mean, it was pretty messed up. I think on that one there, I was able to get a screw in there and over there. But these ones, I think she has to bow a little bit more, probably over time as it gets wet. And with usage, it should conform more. But it took the whole, popped it back out the bottom of the canoe, and it's looking pretty good now. All right, so we're gonna get this on. I guess we're gonna get this on the top of the Jeep and head down and try this in the water. Oh wait, I gotta do a mortar mount first. Let's do the mortar mount. Got the mortar mount in. Pretty sturdy. Only downfall is when I went that route, it took a bit of my seat, so I might add some plywood and add a bigger seat. It's kind of hurting my back now, but it is a mount. I'll definitely hook up my little electric trolling engine on that, and there'll be room underneath there somewhere for the battery. Let's go! Bunch of haze coming in from Tantallon. There's a, what kind of fire is it?
Wildfire.
Wildfire up in Tantallon. They we're out in the passage right now, but it is coming in from over there. Must be pretty big. They already destroyed a couple cottages up there. It's nuts. Well, Irving, gonna grab a couple polar pops. Cause that's how we Scotian live in with this lifestyle. Polar pop. Oh, surprised me. Some diet. I'm gonna go look for that cheese. What? Yeah. All right. Get this large. Yeah.
Only Diet Coke.
Yeah, sure, diet. I need some diet. Ah, that's what I came here for. Love this cheese. Well, it seems like Irving got it, eh? It's like some Montreal salted cheese. Addicted to that shit. As you can see, we are on our maiden voyage. I am pretty impressed with... this hasn't been taken in water at all. That Gorilla flex tape is pretty impressive. Pretty impressive. Everything's holding up pretty good. The little trolling motor's working good. 2x4 never broke in half yet. Even a little weight. A little weight behind us. I guess we're off to try to find some big ones. Thanks for watching. What? Yeah. Well, there gotta be something over there. Look, there's all kinds of seagulls over there, eh? Thank you.
be some fish there or something. A pile of seagulls just hanging out there. Should have brought the drone, but I was tired from working on this all day in the sun. I think I'm gonna add, next time I'm gonna add along the side of this. A lot of people, they put that foam along the side to stop it from being so tippy. Wow, I'll tell you, that fire emergency alert for Tantallon is bad. This shit is bad. They just had a second warning now for emergency oxygen warning for the area. But what a view from here. We're out on the Cow Bay Pond right now. Kayaker is this crazy kayaker, but they're trying to keep up with us. Should I send it?
Sending it.
So yeah, all in all, it went well. The patches and everything, they all held up very well. Never had a leak. She's bone dry. But coming back in, the trolling motor hit a ground. And yeah, this snapped off. So I'm gonna have to make a better mount somehow. I mean, I thought that should have been strong enough. Maybe when I notched it out here, that was like a weak point. Right? Like, fuck, everything's like, geez, solid. But, I don't know, maybe it should have been reinforced with metal or something. Anyways, we'll try to make it better next time we go out. Yeah, this stuff works pretty good. Because, I mean, like, we had to pull this up on a beach with rocks. Stuff's not even fully cured yet, but it's just hard as hell. No, not a fucking scratch. Not a scratch. It's amazing, amazing, amazing product. So I guess we'll have to do like a 1 year review on this stuff and see how it's holding up after a year and let you know. Let me know if you have any idea with another engine mount system.